House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls,
you're listening to House of Cards.
Today, the game is different.
I want to gamble.
Gambling is a very serious business.
Is that clear?
Welcome to House of Cards. Dave Weishaupt with you here, deep from the swamps of Jersey. We got a great show coming up for you. We waited a long time. Now it's happened. Pennsylvania has finally gone live with their online casinos. What casinos have hit the internet? What games are they offering? And what can we expect in the future from the Keystone State? We're going to talk all about it with one of the best gambling writers in the country, Steve Ruddick. We're going to talk all about what's going on and what can we expect from Pennsylvania in the future. My conversation with Steve right after this. So stick around. We'll be right back with House of Cards. House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com.
Yeah, you, come here. Haven't you heard? We don't need to hide anymore. Now, we can shop privately for adult products at adamandeve.com. They've got massage oils, lingerie, and lots more we can't mention here. Use offer code SPICE404. They'll give you 50% off almost any one item, 3 free DVDs, free mystery gift, and free shipping. That's 50% off, free shipping, and more. Private shopping starts at adamandeve.com.
You're listening to House of Cards.
The answer is probably we're finished.
What are the odds? One in 100?
I don't do odds. I gave very detailed.
You ran casinos, sir.
Welcome back to House of Cards. Dave Weishottle with you. Well, it finally happened. Pennsylvania has gone live with their online casinos, something that a lot of people have been waiting for a long time. So what did we see from the rollout? What casinos went live? And what can we expect from Pennsylvania going forward? To help us answer these questions, I'm going to be talking with Steve Ruddick. Steve's articles can be found at onlinepokerreport.com and playnj.com. And in my opinion, he's one of the best gambling writers in the country. And we are lucky to have him with us today. Steve, thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
You know, before we start talking about specific sites, I want to ask you a question that our listeners have been asking us for a long time at this radio show. What took Pennsylvania so long to go live with their online casinos?
That's a very good question. There's probably a combination of elements that factored into that. For one thing, when they legalized online gambling, they did it in conjunction with a number of other gaming expansions. Some of which took precedent over the online gambling. So the state regulators were really tasked with a lot of different things to go over and cover. And I think online gambling just kind of fell down into the well, and it was picked up when it was ready to go. The other thing is you still had some Pennsylvania operators that weren't overly thrilled with online gambling or the prospects of it. They felt it would either dig into their existing business or level the playing field a little bit. So I think you had a lot of different things should be regulated, how many skins a site should be able to have, things like that. So you had a lot of just discussion over those things, and I think that just stalled things out a little bit.
You know, I know the fees in Pennsylvania and the tax rate was crazy. Was that a deterrent to any of these sites going forward quicker?
I would assume that they would want to get them up and running as soon as possible after paying $10 to $12 million and, you know, having to deal with the tax rates that are coming. But yeah, I know that it was a very, very burdensome amount of money. There's a lot of talk about would sites even pay for that, but obviously most of the casinos in the state did, and the ones that didn't were kind of expected not to.
So right now, as we speak, what are the Pennsylvania's online casino sites? I believe right now there are three, correct?
Yeah, so that's correct at the moment. That could change in the next 15 minutes. I'm not really sure. Yeah, but you have Parks, you have Penn National's Hollywood Casino, and you have the Rush Street Sugar House Casino.
Now, when someone in Pennsylvania logs onto these online casinos, are they basically seeing the finished product with regard to all the games that the sites are offering, or is this going to be a gradual rollout for some of these sites, and they're going to be adding games as they go on?
Yeah, this will definitely be a slow build. We saw that even in New Jersey, where, I mean, sites launched a little more complete than they did in Pennsylvania. These are some pretty bare bones as far as game titles and things of that sort. I think you'll see a lot more coming online over the months and years. I believe Golden Nugget is now over 600 different games. And, I mean, when they launched, it was probably in the 50 range. So it takes a while to build up those games, to build up partnerships with different content providers. So you have all these different online slot producers, and you have to enter into agreements to use their titles and things of that nature. So it does take a while to build up your catalog of games. And also, I would assume that the regulators want to make sure that each type of game is functioning as it's stated it's supposed to. So you might see more table games come online as things go on.
You know, whenever a new sports book or a new online casino goes live, you know, people start judging these sites against each other by the introductory offers or the promotions that these sites offer. Are most of the introductory offers that we've seen out of Pennsylvania pretty much the same thing, or does one offer stand above the other offers, or are we going to see some things in the coming weeks from these three sites?
Yeah, so I haven't really dug into the intro offers too much. Generally speaking, they kind of even out. So if you have one site that's offering $1,000, maybe their clear rate is a little lower than the site that's offering $200. So there's a difference. You know, I think these sites have pretty much figured it out over the years. about how much money they offer and how that money is cleared to the player. I think that's the bigger thing that anybody should look at is what's the clear rate of the offer and, you know, is there an expiration date on it? So if somebody's offering you $2,000, but you get to clear it in, you know, 30 days and it's almost impossible, then they're not really offering you $2,000.
Stick around. We'll be right back with House of Cards. House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com. Stick around. We'll be right back with House of Cards.
You're listening to House of Cards.
Where was the house? Where was the house of cards?
Welcome back to House of Cards. Dave Weishaupt with you. For those of you just joining us, I'm talking with Steve Ruddick from OnlinePokerReport.com. Talk to me about the rollout itself. Are the people you're talking to pleased about the initial week, or did you hear any concerns, whether it be from the people who work in the casino business or the people who have played on the sites? Generally speaking, what was the reaction to the rollout itself?
So far, so good. You have the typical little hiccups that you're going to get whenever you launch something new. Those are pretty much unavoidable, so I wouldn't really put too much stock in that, but there hasn't been any widespread failures or outages or anything of that sort. New Jersey had definitely more problems.
I was just about to say that. I mean, I'm sitting here talking to you from New Jersey, and I remember when the New Jersey online casinos went live. One of those glitches was the geolocation software. I'm sure technology has improved since Jersey went online. Have you heard any problems with the geolocation in regard to the new online casinos in Pennsylvania?
No, they've really hammered that out over the years. I mean, New Jersey's got 6 years experience on this now, so it's starting to get just what you need to do. I mean, the two states are in communication with each other, the regulators, the operators. A lot of them are like operators. There are in both states, so they already know how these procedures work. And again, when New Jersey rolled out, it was pretty much brand new. Delaware and Nevada had online gambling, but it wasn't really at this level of it. So it was a trial and error for New Jersey, and Pennsylvania is benefiting from that.
I can tell you about the geolocation when it first came out in New Jersey. I mean, I have a place in New Jersey about 7 miles from the Delaware River. In my living room, I could play online, but in my bedroom, I was too close to Pennsylvania, and it's not a big house. That's how weird the geolocation was in New Jersey when it came out.
It was very finicky.
It was
early on, but that was by design. The regulators were overburdening the geolocation companies to make sure that there was no chance that there would be a false positive. False negatives were okay. Mm-hmm.
You know, I also remember in New Jersey when they rolled out the online casinos, some of the banks in Jersey wouldn't be involved in the deposit of money to some of the sites. Has there been any problems with regard to deposits or withdrawals in the banks of Pennsylvania with regard to the new casino sites?
I think you're still seeing that in New Jersey.
Yeah.
What I think we've discovered over the last 6 years is that there are alternative methods, and the providers, so your online gambling sites, know what bank credit cards work, which ones don't. So they're capable of steering customers towards preferred methods. And if you're denied now, I know early on in New Jersey, if you were denied, you really didn't know why.
Yeah.
So you weren't really sure what was going on. So now it's more, you'll get a pop-up message saying you might want to try this, you know, this alternative method, whether it's, I don't think Pennsylvania has a lot of alternative methods at this time, but I sort of like the game catalogs. Those things will get rolled out as the months go on.
You know, I know you talk to a lot of officials in Pennsylvania doing your articles, and has Pennsylvania officials tempered their expectations with regard to online casinos? Because I know when New Jersey first rolled out the online casinos, the expectations were crazy, and there was no way these sites can meet those expectations. In Pennsylvania, have they put forth more reasonable estimates on how much revenue these sites can bring in?
Yeah, so once again, Pennsylvania can thank New Jersey for totally missing on their revenue expectations. So what they got from analysts was a much more tempered amount of money that they can bring in. I think the expectations are pretty reasonable. They're pretty much in line. So most of them are basing it off the New Jersey model and just adjusting for, you know, a number of operators and population and that sort of thing. So there's really, if they miss the mark, it'll be very close.
You mentioned they're following the New Jersey model and they're offering all the casino games. However, right now, online poker is not available in Pennsylvania right now. Is there a reason why online poker was excluded from the initial rollout from these online casinos?
Yeah, I'm not sure it was excluded. I think it was just, it's not the economic driver that the online casino games are. And I think a lot of the operators were much more interested in getting their online casinos up and running. New Jersey's, I believe, online poker is about 5% to 8% of monthly revenue.
Yeah.
So they're going with their big moneymaker. Online poker will come out as time goes on. I was a little surprised that no online poker sites were ready to roll out, just because some of them will be integrated in with the casino software. So it could be a testing thing. It could just be that they prioritized online casino.
You know, one of the questions we've gotten here at the radio show that, and this probably is a question that has to be answered further down the road. When online poker does go live in Pennsylvania, do you think that Pennsylvania will try and be involved in the compact between Nevada, New Jersey, and Delaware with regard to shared player pools for online poker players? Or has the new definition of the Wire Act really put a discussion like that on hold?
It could be. Let's answer the first part of that question, which is a definite yes.
Okay.
Pennsylvania has always looked ahead to that eventuality, that they'll join the multi-state poker. The Wire Act, yeah, so that's kind of the cloud hanging over the whole thing, what is and isn't allowed. That will probably slow it down. If they had planned to do it, you know, before the end of the first year, that might not be the case anymore. So it might have slowed that down, stalled that out a little bit. But as an eventuality, that will definitely be the case. And, I mean, the Wire Act seems to be working out in favor of the 2011 opinion and not the latest opinion that was rendered.
So right now there are three online casinos in Pennsylvania: Rivers Casino, Play Sugar House, and Parks. Out of those three, has anyone really shown the brightest in this first week, or is it just way too early to tell?
It's pretty early to tell. I mean, online casinos are fairly similar. Play Sugar House does really well in the New Jersey market, so the Rush Street software seems to be very popular with players, so I wouldn't expect any different in Pennsylvania. Penn National's casino is new to the market. Parks is using GAN, which has some experience in New Jersey as well, and has had good success there. So it's interesting to see what draws players into the casinos. Is it the software? Is it the bonuses you were talking about? Is it games? Is it brand recognition? I think all of those things get thrown into a pot and people make their determination.
Stick around. We'll be right back with House of Cards. House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com. Stick around. We'll be right back with House of Cards. Hey, this is Dave Whiteshadow from House of Cards with your House of Cards gaming report for the week of July 29, 2019. DraftKings has become the official daily fantasy game of the PGA Tour. DraftKings and the PGA entered into a multi-year marketing and content partnership in which DraftKings will offer fantasy contests that include tournaments and showdowns where participants can win cash and prizes from the PGA Tour. Real-time video will also be provided for players who are picked on an individual's fantasy team. Not only was June the one-year anniversary of the Ocean Casino in Atlantic City, but it was also the property's best month ever. The casino had its highest occupancy month for its hotel, had their highest slot revenue, as well as their highest gaming revenue in its history. The Ocean Casino took over the shuttered Revel Casino property on the boardwalk on June 28th of last year. And finally, fans of the video game Grand Theft Auto now can stop at their own online casino. After 6 years of rumors, the Diamond Casino and Resort has opened in the popular video game. For a membership fee of $500, players of Grand Theft Auto Online will receive chips and can start playing in the virtual casino. Sounds like that game got even more fun. Have any news or tips regarding casinos, gaming, or legislation? Send us an email at newsroom at houseofcardsradio.com and follow us on Twitter at HOC Radio.
You're listening to the House of Cards.
Well, don't take it too hard. I did a lot of stupid things in my life, too.
Stupid? What do you mean, stupid?
Welcome back to House of Cards. Dave Weishuttle with you here. For those of you just joining us, I'm talking with Steve Ruddick from OnlinePokerReport.com. Is there one online casino in Pennsylvania, whether it's live now or down the road, is there one casino to really keep an eye on that everyone thinks is going to do well? I remember in New Jersey, everyone's, oh, just wait till Borgata comes out. They're going to blow the market away. Is there one like that in Pennsylvania that everyone's waiting to see either they're live or coming down the road?
Yeah, I think people have expectations that the bigger players will be the better online casinos. But I think New Jersey has borne that out, that that isn't quite the case.
Nope.
It's generally, I'm interested in 3 months from now. I think we'll know who is embracing online gambling and who is, you know, got dragged into it. So I think in New Jersey, you could use the Caesars or Borgata instance where these are huge money-making casinos. So online gambling is kind of a less prioritized offering. But you have a casino like Golden Nugget or Resorts, which, you know, they make money, but they don't make the type of money that the larger casinos make. So to them, online gambling is a great opportunity. So I think when you look at, if you look at Pennsylvania, you want to look at the casinos that are profitable but aren't huge revenue generators. Those are the casinos that should be embracing it.
No, you just mentioned it. I wanted to ask about that. One of the great stories coming out of New Jersey online casinos is Golden Nugget. I mean, I think the online casino is bringing in just as much revenue as the brick-and-mortar casino. Do you think Pennsylvania is going to take a page out of the Golden Nugget playbook and adopt what they're doing? I mean, are we going to start seeing live dealers across the state of Pennsylvania with their online sites?
Yeah, that's a definite. When that happens, I don't know. There's testing and stuff that has to take place. There's definitely some of the operators are already talking about live dealer games.
Really?
And that's a big generator. I know that just from some back channel chatter, I've heard that there's a live dealer studio. So there's stuff going on that front. The problem with taking the Golden Nugget playbook is everybody can see it now. So when Golden Nugget did it, everything was new. They were taking risks. But now every casino knows, well, this isn't really a risk. This is the investment we need to make. So I think it will be a little hard for people to mimic what Golden Nugget did early on. But there is obviously they should be doing what Golden Nugget did. But I think everybody will be doing it.
Well, sticking with Golden Nugget, I mean, they've become the number one online site in New Jersey, and they don't offer online poker. Do you think that's showing some of the operators in Pennsylvania that, you know what, maybe we just don't need online poker and let's make other things a priority and just roll out without offering poker?
Sure. I think there's a few casinos that are going to do that. Some of them didn't apply for the online poker license. So there'll be several that don't offer it. I mean, there's only so you can only have so many online poker sites in a market just because of liquidity.
Sure.
Whereas online casino, you don't really have that problem. Golden Nugget has shown that you don't need online poker. I don't think they really needed to show it, though. I think people know that just intuitively that, you know, it's just not the revenue generator. But at the same time, if Golden Nugget could offer online poker and do so profitably, they would in a heartbeat. It's a different clientele. It's a different way to bring new people into your casino. So there's opportunities with online poker. It's just maybe not so much on the revenue side.
You know, whenever a state does something big with regard to gambling, I always look at the ripple effect to the other states bordering it. I know a bunch of years ago when Atlantic City wasn't doing very well, it blamed Pennsylvania and them getting casinos. How do you think online casinos will affect New Jersey and West Virginia and Ohio with regard to the casinos in their states? Or is online casinos just a different animal and, you know, they're really not going to impact the border states too much?
Yeah, so it's probably a little bit of both. It's definitely a different animal. There's not a ton of crossover between your retail customer and your online customer. But where there is a crossover, those are probably some of your top customers. So they're very important customers. I think what you'll see as Pennsylvania gets going is the people in New Jersey and, you know, eastern Pennsylvania that probably go to both casinos. They might go to Atlantic City sometimes. They might go to Parks, Harrah's, wherever in Pennsylvania. Those people will have an option because if they say they work in New Jersey and they live in Pennsylvania, if when they're in New Jersey, they're earning points to Atlantic City casinos. Mm-hmm. So they're getting drawn there. So now they have a chance when they're home, they can earn points to the Pennsylvania casinos. So are they still going to keep playing when they're in New Jersey and vice versa? I think you'll start to see those border populations start to, you know, pick where they're going to be playing, which casino is, you know, giving them the best rewards, which is the most convenient to where they are.
You raise a great point because I live in New Jersey, but my closest casino is Parks. So it'd be interesting to see how the points and the comps really ring up in terms of the people living along the coast.
Yeah, sure. There was, I know one of Parks's big gripes early on about online gambling was that they lost a lot of poker players when New Jersey started online poker.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the New Jersey players who would drive to Parks to play poker were now playing online as well, but they're playing on New Jersey sites and earning rewards at New Jersey casinos. So that was keeping them away from Parks and those other casinos. They were going to Atlantic City instead because, like, well, I already have points here.
Yeah, sure. Sure.
So there was that dynamic going on. And I know Parks was griping about the percentage of their New Jersey customers that they had lost. So we'll see if those customers come back now. Well, it'll be one of the interesting underlying stories to follow.
So what can we expect next in the state of Pennsylvania? Who's going to roll out with the next online casino in the Commonwealth?
Your guess is as good as mine there.
It
depends when the Gaming Control Board had them in the testing pipeline, and I mean, when their licenses were approved, things of that sort.
What is Pennsylvania's priority now? I know I'm talking to a lot of people in Pennsylvania, and they're really focusing on the sports books and the online sports books and the online casinos. You know, sure, people are talking about them, but there's not that sense of excitement that the sports books has. What is the general feeling in Pennsylvania? What is their priority?
Yeah, so sports betting is the topic of the day.
Yeah.
So everybody, even if it's not the biggest revenue generator, it's on everybody's mind, and it's really grabbing national headlines and mainstream media. So beyond, you know, the gaming media, which is covering the online casino launch, but you're not really seeing much about that in mainstream media, but you are seeing sports betting stuff. It's just a sexier topic right now. I mean, they have other priorities too. I mean, the mini casinos are going, once they really get moving on those, that's going to be one of the top priorities for regulators and for operators. I mean, if you have the option of building a new casino, that's pretty much where most of your time and energy is going to be focused.
Yeah.
So, I mean, so many moving parts in Pennsylvania right now that it's hard to really pin down how these operators are juggling all of those things.
Steve, we're running out of time, but I want to let you tell people where they can read your articles and how they can follow you on social media.
Yeah, you can find me at onlinepokerreport.com or any of our Play Network sites, which are like your playnj.com, playusa.com, playpennsylvania.com. That's one that your readers will probably, or your listeners will probably want to check out if they're interested in the Pennsylvania market. And social media, just hit me up on Twitter at Steve Ruddick.
You know, here at the radio show, when anyone wants to know anything about the gambling world, Steve Ruddick is required reading. So, Steve, thanks for coming on and telling us what's going on in Pennsylvania.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me.
Stick around. We'll be right back with more House of Cards. House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com. Borgata made history by becoming the first Atlantic City casino to offer land-based sports betting. Now, 1 year later, Borgata adds to its history by launching its own online sports betting platform, BorgataSports.com. BorgataSports.com players can enjoy the same range of sports bets currently offered at Borgata's land-based sportsbook, the new Moneyline Bar and Book. You'll find straight bets, parlay bets, live in-game betting, and much, much more at BorgataSports.com. And now when you sign up at BorgataSports.com using our promo code HOUSE, that's H-O-U-S-E, you get a risk-free bet up to $250 and 20 bonus dollars at BorgataCasino.com. Borgata has made history again with BorgataSports.com. Sign up today with promo code HOUSE and get your risk-free bet up to $250 and your $20 bonus money at BorgataCasino.com. Your favorite casino is now your favorite sportsbook, available anywhere in New Jersey. BorgataSports.com. Must be 21 years or older and in New Jersey to place a bet. Terms and conditions apply. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. Join the best and the brightest of the esports industry on September 4th and 5th at the Luxor Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas for this year's Casino Esport Conference, brought to you by Clarion Gaming and Fox Marketing. CEC Vegas brings together online and land-based gaming operators with professionals from all avenues of the esport industry. This two-day conference and exhibition will allow attendees to discover new revenue and traffic through esports events and wagering. CEC Vegas is the premier event to meet, share ideas, and explore a wealth of product and service solutions to find the best way forward in the lucrative market of esports. Panels include experts discussing wagering, social media gaming, the latest technology, and much, much more. Don't wait. Head on over to CasinoEsportsConf.com and register today to attend this exciting and unique look at the esports industry. The Casino Esport Conference, brought to you by Clarion Gaming and Fox Marketing, September 4th and 5th at the Luxor Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas. It's one event you can't afford to miss. Stick around. We'll be right back with more House of Cards. House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com.
Yeah, you, come here. Haven't you heard? We don't need to hide anymore. Now, we can shop privately for adult products at adamandeve.com. They've got massage oils, lingerie, and lots more we can't mention here. Use offer code SPICE404. They'll give you 50% off almost any one item, 3 free DVDs, free mystery gift, and free shipping. That's 50% off, free shipping, and more. Private shopping starts at adamandeve.com.
You're listening to the House of Cards with Ashley Adams.
He was king at five card stud. The stranger's game was five card stud. He was hard to beat. Rather play than eat. Long as it was five card stud. When he played, he played.
Welcome back, listeners. This is Ashley Adams. You're listening to my favorite segment of House of Cards, which is the mailbag segment. I'm joined in studio by Dave Weishattle, who has some questions for me.
House of Cards is brought to you by Drizly, your online liquor store. Available in over 95 cities across North America, Drizly offers a huge selection and competitive pricing with a side of personalized content. Now there's no need to leave the house. Get alcohol delivered in less than an hour by Drizly. Head on over to drizly.com and order today. And now get $5 off your first order of $20 or more when using promo code DRINK19 at checkout. Shop beer, wine, and liquor with drizly.com.
What's that number again, Dave?
That's 609-474-HOCR, which is 4627. And remember, if we use your question on the air, you get a party poker baseball hat.
Well, we got Steve from New York, and a lot of people ask this question. If I'm in a tournament and I'm tired from long play or it's a late night tournament, I tend to play too fast without full thought into what my opponents may have. Do you have any advice on fighting the fatigue factor when I play?
Caffeine?
Nope.
Not playing?
See, that doesn't work for me. I drink coffee and then I got to go to the bathroom every 2 seconds.
Well, that's another option. You can just go to the bathroom.
Go to the bathroom every 2 seconds.
No, I mean, I think people have to either have endurance or they don't. You know, the obvious stuff, which I'm coming up with off the top of my head, not as a poker expert, but get plenty of sleep the night before. Don't drink alcohol and caffeinated beverages because that will dehydrate you and deplete you and end up wearing you down. Having a good balanced meal, plenty of vegetables, say your prayers, all that crap. But I don't have any magic solution to how to avoid getting tired in the middle of the night following a long tournament. Increasingly, they are structuring tournaments, especially the major ones, so they don't become endurance affairs, so that they end at a reasonable time and they continue the next day. But there are Ironman tournaments, and there are tournaments that are just structured to start. I mean, I play in a tournament that starts on the early side of the day instead of I wouldn't play in a 5 o'clock tournament. I'd play in the 11 a.m. tournament. I wouldn't play in a 7 p.m. tournament if I know that the structure is going to have me playing until 4 in the morning if I can't, you know, keep my best level of play throughout. So that's all the advice I can offer.
I was always meaning to ask you, you know, everyone, we get these questions about how do you relax during a tournament? What's your endurance like? I was in a poker room and I saw, you know, I'm sure you have too, masseuses.
Oh, yeah.
Come around.
Massage therapist.
I've never tried that. And I don't see, I don't think that would get me too relaxed. You know, I would be falling asleep. I mean,
I've had many massages at the table.
Really?
Yeah, of course, being the cheapskate, my only interest is what do they charge? And they used to charge at the Trop in Atlantic City, it was $15 for 20 minutes.
Wow. Okay.
And that was great. Then it was a buck an hour, pretty good. And now, invariably...
You mean a buck a minute?
A buck a minute.
Because I'll buy a buck a minute.
And now, invariably, it's $2 a minute. So if I want a 15-minute massage, it's $30. And...
Plus, I guess you got a tip, too.
And you got a tip. Yeah. I mean, I always want a tip. But so I don't do it. For $2 a minute, I think that's too much. So,
other than the cash considerations, how do you feel better after
they
do it? And can you concentrate on the cards?
Yeah. Although, increasingly, I will ask for the massage and not play because I don't want to be distracted by the hand. I want to be fully immersed in the massage experience. It's only a neck, shoulder, and back massage. Right. They don't do anything else. But if you're in Las Vegas, I got to just add this as a plug, reflexology. There are folks that give massages for an hour.
Really?
For $25 in Chinatown on Spring Mountain.
Oh, okay.
Wonderful. You got to do it. If you're ever in Las Vegas, get the reflexology massage.
Now, that's not the hot rocks or anything like that. Or that's like you're pushing on pressure points, right?
Reflexology is your feet.
Okay.
And then you have the option of full body massage while you're there, which I recommend highly.
You know, I tried doing that at the table. You know, I try that once in a while.
Full body
massage? Yeah, right at the table. Why not?
You could probably earn more money giving massages than playing poker, Dave.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. The way I play? Yeah, probably.
So I guess that'll do it?
That'll do it.
Make sure to come back next week for more House of Cards. Slow.